Welcome, dear learners. In this session, we are going to see Introduction to Marketing Part 2. We will be learning difference between marketing and selling, relevant terms on marketing, importance of marketing, and objectives of marketing. If you see the difference, marketing includes selling and other activities like various promotional measures, marketing research, after-sales services, etc. Whereas selling is confined to persuasion of consumers to buy the firm's goods and services. So, if you can see that, selling is a part of marketing only. In case of marketing, it starts with the research on consumer needs, wants, preference, likes, dislikes, etc. and continues even after the sales have taken place. So, even before we produce the products, by finding out what the customer wants, that is the most important aspect of marketing. So, it starts with the research on the consumer needs, whereas selling starts after the production process is over and ends with the handing over of the money to the seller by the buyer. In case of marketing, the focus is on earning profit through maximization of customers' needs. In the previous session itself, we have seen that the profit is increased by maximizing the customer's satisfaction. Whereas in selling, the focus is on earning the profit through maximization of sales. Fragmented approach to achieve short-term gain is the main thing in selling. In marketing, it is an integrated approach to achieve long-term goals like creating, maintaining, and retaining the customers. This is a very important aspect of marketing. That is, it creates the customers by finding out what they want and including those features in the products, and by maintaining the quality, they are able to maintain the customers and also they retain the customers. In case of selling, all activities revolve around the product that has been produced. So, here in selling, the one and only focus is on the product that has already been produced. Now, let us see the important terms of marketing. The first term is market. What is a market in commerce? Market is a place where goods are bought and sold. You can see the picture where all the goods are bought and sold, not only goods, but goods and services which are bought and sold, that place is called as market. But in the context of marketing, market refers to a group of buyers for a particular product or service. So, you can see the difference there. It referred to a place, but in case of marketing, whenever we use the word market, it refers to group of buyers for a particular product or a service. For example, if you see, market for accountancy textbooks will be students in commerce and specialized accountancy programs. Same way, you can see the other examples. Market for machines will be manufacturing industries, and market for toys will be children. So, you must have understood, in marketing, the word market is used to denote the buyers, collective buyers who are interested in the product. The next term is marketeer. It refers to the person who organizes various marketing activities like market research, product planning, pricing, distribution. So, the person who conceives the concept of what to produce by doing marketing research, and the person who actually do the planning of the product, who prices the product, and who is actually involved in distribution of the product to the consumers, he is called as the marketer. Next is seller. Seller refers to a person or organization who is directly involved in the process of exchange of goods and services for money. So, if a person is exchanging goods or selling his services to a person in return for money, he is called as the seller. Now, sellers can be wholesalers or they can be retailers. Who is a wholesaler? Wholesaler is a person who buys goods in bulk from the manufacturer and sells the goods in bulk. Bulk means in large quantities to the retailers. And retailers are the people you can see in the residential areas and other places. They buy the goods in large quantity from the wholesalers and sell it in smaller quantities to the ultimate consumers. Now comes buyer. A buyer is one who is directly involved in the process of purchase of goods and services. So, a person who goes to the market, buys goods and services by paying money, he or she is called the buyer of the goods and services. So, he or she is the one who selects the goods, makes the payment and takes the delivery of the goods. Now, let's see who is a consumer. Consumer is a person who actually uses the product or the service. One has to be very careful in defining a consumer. He is the one, not only he buys the product, he uses the product or service for himself. That person is called as the consumer. For example, if you bought a shirt and gifted it to your friend who uses it, then who is the consumer here? Your friend is the consumer and you become a buyer. Because you paid the money and bought the shirt, so you become the buyer. But who is using the shirt? Your friend is using the shirt, so your friend becomes the consumer. However, if you use the shirt for yourself, you can become the consumer also. So, however, a consumer can also be the buyer. Now, who is the customer? A customer usually refers to a person who takes the buying decision. He may not be buying the product, but he takes the buying decision. A father deciding to buy something, a mother deciding to buy something, they become the customers. In a family, a mother decides on the brand of the shampoo to be used by her children. Now, who takes the decision of buying? Mother takes the decision of buying, so she becomes the customer and the children who are actually using the shampoo becomes the consumer. And a customer can be the consumer also. For example, if mother makes the decision of buying a particular brand of shampoo and she herself uses the shampoo, then she is both the customer as well as the consumer. Buyer may be different from the customer. For example, if mother makes the decision of buying a particular brand of shampoo, but if she sends her son to buy the shampoo, then son becomes the buyer, and since the mother is using the shampoo, she becomes the consumer. Now, one can be the customer and the buyer also. See the example here. For example, if mother makes the decision of buying a particular brand of shampoo and she herself goes to buy the shampoo, then she is buying it, so she becomes the buyer and she is taking the decision, so she is the customer also. So, a person can be a customer as well as the buyer. Now, what is a virtual market? With advancement of technology, the buyer and the sellers can nowadays interact with each other by using internet. Commonly, it is called as online shopping. These kind of markets by using the internet is called as virtual market. What is the importance of marketing? Better products and services. Marketing helps to ascertain consumers' needs and wants. It helps to improve the existing products. It leads to the introduction of new products. And marketing also improves the standard of living of the people. So, first it finds out what they require and whatever is the existing products, as per the needs of the consumers, it adds on new features to the existing products, and sometimes it comes out with the new products itself, and by doing all these things, it helps the customers to improve their standard of living. You can see that this picture. In olden days, the washing machine had two tubs, you know, where one we have to wash in one tub, then take out the clothes, and manually we have to put it in the other tub, then that rotates and then the drying happens. But these days you just open it, fill the powder and close it, and then everything is done automatically. So this is how features are added with the existing product. Same way previously we had only black and white televisions. Now we have LED TVs, color television, and many others have come into place. And marketing creates time and place utilities. Marketing helps in making products available at all places and throughout the year. As we all know, products are produced in different places or grown in different places, but the demand is in various other places. So this is possible due to warehousing and proper packaging. If you can see, Kashmir shawls are available in other parts of India. How? Through transporting them, by storing them and sending them to various places. Same way, tea which is grown in Assam is available all over India. Nowadays it is being exported to other countries also. So all these things are possible only through marketing. Marketing also helps in the development of economy. Various activities like advertising, personal selling, packaging, transportation, etc. generate employment for a large number of people and accelerate growth of the business. For example, advertising, you need lot of people. Personal selling, you need lot of people. Packaging, transportation, everywhere you need employees. So as a result, it promotes employment growth, and in turn it improves the growth of the business as well as the development of the economy. If you can see the functions of marketing, like advertising, personal selling and transportation, it generates employment that helps the growth of the business, which in turn helps in the development of the economy. So the success of the business increases its sales volume, it generates revenue, and it ensures its success in the long run. And it helps to meet competition. Marketing helps the business in meeting competition most effectively, because lot of marketing research is done even before the products are produced. If you can see the picture, the seller is wondering, my competitor has reduced the price, so I must also reduce the price to increase the demand for the product. Now let us study about the objectives of marketing. The first and foremost objective of marketing is to provide satisfaction to the consumers. So we ascertain consumer needs, then we produce goods that satisfy the needs, and then the pricing and distribution takes place as planned by the marketer. The next objective of marketing is to increase in demand. Through advertising and other sales promotional efforts, marketing aims at creating additional demand for the products. By making the customer satisfied, you can create new customers also. For example, if you buy a gel pen and feel satisfied, next time also you will buy the same pen. And obviously, when you tell others about it, they will also feel like giving it a try. So the satisfied customers, when they pass the message through the word of mouth, other customers are also introduced and the demand automatically increases. The next objective is, it provides better quality product to the customers. The business houses try to update and upgrade their knowledge and technology to continuously provide better products. If they do not do so, they will be phased out through competition. So continuous research and development process keeps on happening in marketing, which helps in developing better quality products to the customers. Next objective is to create goodwill for the organization. Goodwill is very important for any organization. So it maintains loyalty to the product and it accepts new products of the same company. It helps the consumers to accept the new products of the same company. It generates profitable sales volume. Taking care of customer needs and wants, provide required goods at prices they can afford, at places convenient to them. By doing all these things, it increases sales and it increases profit. In this session, we have learnt the difference between marketing and selling, relevant terms on marketing, importance of marketing, and also the objectives of marketing. I hope all of you would have understood all these topics in a proper way. Thank you.